we are going to see a predictive data feature exploration based air quality prediction approach. Introduction. Air quality prediction is crucial for monitoring and managing environmental pollution, public health and safety. Accurate forecasts help governments, organizations and individuals take proactive measures to mitigate the impact of poor air quality on human health and the environment. Statistical methods like regression and machine learning techniques capture linear dependencies and patterns, while deep learning models capture complex interactions among data features. Objective of the project. This project combines predictive data with historical and meteorological data using machine learning methods. LightGBM is used to predict air quality, and the model compares RMSE error rates with other algorithms like AdaBoost, GPDT, XGBoost, and DNNs. The lower the RMSE rate, the better the predicted model is. The air quality dataset includes PM2.5 and PM10 quality values, which are our target variables. To execute this project, these are the requirements needed. The hardware requirements needed are operating system of Windows, processor of i5 and above, RAM of 4GB and above, hard disk of 20GB and above. The software requirements needed are Python IDEL, that is Python 3.7 version. To execute this project, we have designed these modules. The first module is upload air quality dataset. Using this module, we will upload dataset to application and then calculate feature importance using correlation formula. The feature which is important for prediction will have high value. The second module is pre-processed dataset. Using this module, we will analyze entire dataset and then remove empty and missing values and encode categorical variables to numeric. The third module is run PM2.5 quality prediction. Using this module, we will predict PM2.5 air quality by using LightGBM, GPDT, XGBoost and DNN algorithms. The next module is run PM10 quality prediction. Using this module, we will predict PM10 air quality by using LightGBM, GPDT, XGBoost and DNNs. The last module is comparison graph. Using this module, we will compare RMSE error rate between all algorithms for PM2.5 and PM10. Execution of the project. To execute this project, first we need to open the code folder. This is the dataset folder in which I have air quality prediction dataset. This is the Python main code file. This is the run.bat file. Instead of executing the program in command line interface, we created Windows bat file to execute the project. Double click on run.bat file. This graphical user interface will be opened. With this, we are interacting with the program. Now click on Upload Air Quality Dataset. A dialog box will be opened. Click on the dataset and click on Open. This is the correlation feature importance graph, and these are column names, and these are values of its correlation feature importance value. Close this tab. And here in this text box, we can see the top 5 rows and the bottom 5 rows of the data set. We can see there are null values in the data and there are categorical variables in the data. So there is need for pre-processing for this data set. Now click on pre-process data set. This is the line graph representing date-wise pollution rate. Close this graph. And here in this text box, we can see these are the top 5 rows of PM2.5 and these are the top 5 rows of PM10. Previously, these are null values, and after pre-processing, the null values are replaced with zeros. Now click on Run PM2.5 Quality Prediction. In this text box, we can see the RMSE values of each model. The gradient boosting decision tree algorithm secured 0.03 RMSE. XGBoost RMSE 0.02. LightGBM RMSE is 0.003. And DNN RMSE is 0.74. We can see this actual versus predicted graph. The red line represents actual values and the green line represents predicted values. The actual versus predicted graph is for each model. In this command line, we can see the predicted and expected values for each row. This is for the model DNN and for PM2.5 column. On day 11, the predicted value is 37, whereas the expected or actual value is 37. It has predicted correctly. And if we see on day 17, the predicted value is 22 and the expected value is 21. It's almost there. Now click on Run PM10 Quality Prediction. Now we can see the PM10's RMSC of each model. The gradient boosting algorithm has given 0.04 RMSC, XJ boost RMSC is 0.03, Light JPM RMSC is 0.004, and DNN's RMSC is 2.29. We can see that Light JPM has secured the least RMSC error rate. And we can see the graph here. This is the actual versus predicted graph. Red line represents actual values and the green line represents predicted values. Close this tab, and in the command line interface we can see the model and predicted and expected value for each day. Now click on comparison graph. We can see the comparison graph of RMSE error rates of each model. We can see DNN model has high RMSE error rate and Light JPM model has the least RMSE error rate. The conclusion here is the Light JPM algorithm is used in this project to efficiently predict air quality from large scale data. The model is compared to other algorithms like AdaBoost, GBDT, XGBoost and DNN with a low RMSE error rate, indicating better prediction. Light JPM outperforms other algorithms in reducing error rates for PM2.5 and PM10.
Thank you for watching video. For more projects please visit our website www.trueprojects.in. For updates on latest project videos, please visit TrueProjects YouTube channel and subscribe.